we bowl off Mellow TV Sports with cricket as Jamaican all-rounder Andre Russell is back in the West Indies T20 international squad for the first time since March of last year, while pacers Sheldon Cottrell and Shane Thomas are back in the folder. Chris Gayle and Fabian Allen are the other Jamaicans in the regional side's 18-member squad for their upcoming series against South Africa, Australia and Pakistan. It also includes the returned Shemron Hitmaier and Hayden Walsh Jr., while Kyron Pollard continuing to lead the side following from a 2-1 home win against Sri Lanka in March. Spinner Sunil Narine continues to miss out, saying he is not yet ready to return to international cricket. Now, the expanded squad maintains the blend of experienced players with exciting young talent as the West Indies continue preparations for the defense of their World Cup title in India in October to November. The provisional squad will quarantine and train in St. Lucia ahead of the first T20 series against South Africa, starting on June 26 at the Grenada International Cricket Stadium. The official squad will subsequently be selected and announced ahead of each series. The rest of the squad is Nicholas Puran, Dwayne Bravo, Fidel Edwards, Andre Fletcher, Jason Holder, Akil Hussain, Evan Lewis, Abed McCoy, and Lendo Simmons. Uncapped all-rounder Prenilan Sobhrayan and fast bowler Lizard Williams, who recently made his T20 debut, have received maiden call-ups to the South Africa Test squad for the two-match series against West Indies in St. Lucia in June. Kyle Vereen, Keegan Peterson, and Sorel Erwe and Marco Jansen are the other uncapped picks in the lineup of 19 to be led by Dean Elgar for the first time. The white ball squad, now led by Themba Bavuma for the fixtures against the West Indies, includes a few surprises with Sisanda Magala and Williams, who were blooded in the recent series against Pakistan, retained. A total of 19 players will travel for the series of 5 T20s in the Caribbean. Jamaican Javel Glenn is one of 7 players who have been retained by the St. Lucia Zooks ahead of this season's Caribbean Premier League, which gets underway on August 28 in St. Kitts and Nevis. Captain Darren Samuel will no longer be a player, but has taken a new role of T20 cricket consultant and as a brand ambassador. The Zooks have retained the core of the team, which took them to the finals of last year. Andre Fletcher, Keswick Williams, Rakeem Caldwell, and Rustin Chase will be returning, having impressed last year. They will be joined by Glenn, Obed McCoy, and Mark Dale. The Zooks have 10 spots left to fill in their squad. Now over to track and field news. Now a mega four-way clash over 100 meters featuring Jamaica's multiple global medalist Shellyann Fraser-Pryce and double Olympic champion Elaine Thompson-Herah is expected to unfold at the opening event of the 2021 Diamond League Series in Gateshead on Sunday. The Jamaican pair will take on Britain's world 200-meter champion Dina Asher-Smith and the USA's world leader Sha'Carri Richardson in what will see the four lining up against each other for the very first time. Fraser-Pryce, Thompson-Herah, and Richardson occupy 3 of the top 6 places on the world all-time list, and with the right conditions in Gateshead, the meeting record of 10.93 could be very well broken. Natasha Morrison and Natalia White are also listed for the women's 100-meter field, as well as Blessing Okabare of Nigeria and Marie-Josée Talu of the Ivory Coast. Also down for action at the meet is Julian Fort in the men's 200 meters. Yannick Brown and Megan Tapper are listed in the 100-meter hurdles. Sharika Jackson and Stephanie Ann McPherson in the women's 400 meters. And Genevieve Russell in the women's 400-meter hurdles. In the field, Kimberly Williams and Shanika Ricketts will take on Colombia's Catherine Ibarguen in the women's triple jump, while Daniel Thomas Dodd is in the women's shot put. We kick it over to football news now. Edinson Cavani welcomed the return of fans back to the Premier League with a brilliant 40-lob goal, but Manchester United were unable to mark the occasion with a victory as relegated Fulham came back to draw 1-1 at Old Trafford today. Elsewhere, Patrick Bamford's 16th Premier League goal of the season helped Leeds United defeat Southampton 2-0 in front of 8,000 fans at the St. Mary's Stadium. The victory takes Leeds up above Arsenal and Everton into 8th position and guarantees Marcelo Bielsa's side a top 10 finish. Southampton remain 14th in the Premier League with one game of the season remaining. Meanwhile, former Manchester United teammates Eric Cantona and Roy Keane have been inducted into the Premier League Hall of Fame. They join Alan Shearer and Thierry Henry, who were the first players to be inducted last month. Cantona joined Sir Alex Ferguson's side from Leeds United in 1992 and won 4 Premier League titles in 5 seasons. The French international scored 70 goals in 156 Premier League appearances for Manchester United before retiring from football in 1997. Irishman Keane was another dominant figure for United, leading them to 7 Premier League titles during his 12 seasons at the club before his departure by mutual consent in 2005. And those are the stories making sports news tonight. We now head back to the news desk with Tamara McHale.